So now for 7th Q, we're gonna go through the terminology of the sword, and this is different sections or parts of the sword. The suka is the handle of the sword, the entire handle here. The suba is the hand guard, this point right here. The saya is the sheath that the sword goes into. The sageo is the cord that is on the side of the saya. The suka kashira is the end cap, the steel end cap that holds the end of the suka and all of the wrappings with it on the end. The ha is the cutting edge of the blade. The mune is the back of the sword, reverse of the cutting edge. The kasaki is the last point of the sword here, the rounded tip part. And the hi is the blood groove. So there's a blood groove that you can actually see right along this part of the sword. And the hamon is this tempered line. So if you can get a close up, you'll actually see a line that's going through the sword that has a wavy pattern to it. And that is the hamon. So these parts of the sword that we've just shown are just basic parts of the sword. There are many other parts, and you can find a lot online for if you're going to get into the sword and how to take apart and clean swords. But we wanted to have people have basic knowledge of the sword because it helps with your study of ninjutsu. So I wanted to go over in 7th Q, we have a little bit of etiquette with the sword. Whenever you're handling a new sword or somebody else's sword, you want to always ask permission, because a sword meant a lot in the old days back in Japan. It's like where they had their a lot of ancient tradition handed down from grandfather to grandson and so on and so forth. So it meant a lot to people. Nowadays we get practice swords that are less than $100 or so, and we just throw them around like they're nothing, but they were held in reverence before. So it's always good to ask a person if you can handle their sword before you do. The other thing is, you never want to touch a blade with your fingers, especially if there's no cleaning kits around, because the acid that's in our sweat can start to affect blades in really bad ways. So it's a good etiquette to never touch anybody's blade of their sword when handling them. And storage of the sword. After you've been using a sword in a session, there's little cleaning kits that have special oils and the right type of cloth with them. You can buy those at sword stores and online, and you're going to want to research those a little bit. You're going to dry wipe the entire sword down after use and then re-oil it again before it goes inside the saya. One of the reasons why is the saya inside has wood that can absorb the oils, and it helps that last longer also, otherwise it gets brittle inside. When you're displaying a sword, one of the quick etiquettes is to have the saya down on the ground, and if you're alone, you can put the cutting edge blade out. If you guys were here with me in the dojo and I was demonstrating the sword, I would turn the blade edge in towards me. This is a courtesy, because in the old days, there's a knowledge if it was facing out that I could just cut instantly, fast, right away. So I want to turn it and have it towards me as etiquette also. There's a lot of different ways of bowing with the sword and putting swords on racks and things like that also, whether it's wartime or peacetime. When bowing with the sword in some of my different sword classes that I've gone to, you're gonna have it in the saya with the blade edge facing away from you. You put it out about a foot distance from your knees so that you can use your hands to bow in between. And they also move it and have it on the side There's different ways, depending on which teacher you're training with, whether the blade edge faces out or in towards you, because of the same thing I mentioned before with the blade edge out. You could draw and cut quickly with this. And if it's facing the wrong way, you're showing more respect that you don't have that ability to go ahead and cut. One of the other things I'd like to show is how to do a secure wrap with the Segale, the sword. So when you're cleaned your sword and you're ready to put it away for its final time, you're gonna take your Segale and you're gonna do the first wrap and pinch your thumb. Do one full wrap around the top of the sword and then come back across the same spot you were holding with your thumb with the secondary wrap. Now you're gonna go under the Suba and hold it. A second wrap under the Suba and hold it. And then on your third wrap around, I leave my thumb in place, bring the cord around one more time, and then tuck it up underneath and pull that until it's nice and tight. And then it gives you a little loop top at the bottom, and that stays in place. So this is one way so that the sword is secure and won't fall out. And this is the proper way to wrap and store a sword. So this is just some of the etiquette. There's much more, but this will give you some basics to start with for 7th Q.